Hey everyone, welcome back to Hackpatch. Today I'm going to finish a project I started by using 3D printing. The project in question lives on my bedside table. It's a knob that controls the lights in my bedroom. This is a physical replacement for virtual controls, which are a virtual replacement for physical controls. Ironic? Yes. More convenient? Also yes. I would also argue more feature-packed than a normal light switch. But first, I'd like to design a nice enclosure to finish up the physical part of the project. My goal with this design is to keep the case regularly shaped, like a square, but also make it as low profile as possible. A decision I had to make was whether to redo the electronics to include a rechargeable battery. I'm using an ESP32C3 from Seed Studio, and it has a battery charger on board. Due to the fact that this device will stay on my bedside table, I have no need for it to be battery powered. However, knowing myself, I will want to make another version of it in the future, and to save myself the headache, I added a space for the battery anyway. Speaking of headaches, you know what they say, building things once is for dunces, building things twice is for fools, but building things thrice is when it gets nice. Okay, fine, even if people don't say that, it was true in this particular instance. On the first try, there were numerous silly mistakes, such as the screws to secure the cover would not be flush with the bottom plate, so they could scratch up the surface the dial is placed on. The glaring issue is that the knob was not in the center. After a bit of measuring, the second try was much closer. However, the cutout for the USB port was too far to the left. Okay, off we go, one more print. Now with the form taken care of, let's talk function. At a base level, I want three modes, each accessed by a number of clicks of the button in succession. The default mode, after 30 seconds of inactivity, is brightness control. Turning the knob clockwise increases the brightness of every light in the room, and counterclockwise lowers it. After two clicks, the global color temperature of the lights can be changed. Clockwise for warmer, counterclockwise for cooler. After three clicks, there is a preset scene cycle mode. These are just some of my favorite Home Assistant scenes, and they cycle through as the knob changes direction. I can always click once to go back to brightness mode, and press and hold to toggle the lights on and off. Pressing and holding twice in succession, a little bit shorter this time, will set the lights back to normal. The way this knob is controlling the lights is via my Home Assistant server. The controller in the knob is running a firmware called ESPHome, which communicates directly with Home Assistant and can trigger a set of automations where I have defined all the behaviors. These automations are pretty specific to my home setup, but I will have a short write-up on hackbatch.com on how I got everything working. Link to that will be in the description. Having used the incomplete version of this project for a while, I'm happy to have the final version all smoothed out. And that's at least one weekend project on the books. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.